The single largest relief project that the United States committed taxpayer dollars to, $124 million to be exact, was a project called Caracol, a textile factory that was built in the northern part of the country that was supposed to create some 60,000 jobs and was supposed to create tremendous economic growth.
There's a problem here already. You see, the earthquake affected the southern part of Haiti. The northern part of the country was entirely unaffected.
But who are the beneficiaries of this? Companies like Gap, Target, and Walmart, to name a few. The Caracol factory was built, but it didn't create 60,000 jobs. It created barely 5,000 jobs. But the major American companies who got textiles tariff-free, made at low wages, benefited enormously.
And the end effect on the Haitians was very, very minimal. If you look at some of the infrastructure projects that were undertaken, the Clintons had very grand plans to build large tracts of homes, and there were contractors that were selected for those projects. Sometimes the contractors had experience, sometimes they did not.
There's one company in Florida that spent $1 million getting equipment into Haiti. They had experience in disaster relief, but according to the owners of that company, they only made a small donation to the Clinton Foundation. And guess what? They didn't get any relief contracts. On the other hand, the contractors who did win the awards were given the opportunity to build homes, and in some instances were supposed to build tens of thousands of homes for Haitians. They ended up building a fraction of that. For instance, the New Settlements Program was supposed to build 15,000 homes for $53 million. Instead, it built 2,600 homes, less than a quarter of the original estimate, for $90 million, or $47 million over budget.
And they got away with it.
So you had contracts going to these relief organizations that were also involved with the Clinton Global Initiative. And you had this one organization, Dahlberg, that was supposed to do an assessment for relocating people that suffered from the earthquake. They determined that people should be moved to a site that happened to be on a cliff that was highly unstable. USAID's Inspector General reviewed Dahlberg's recommendations and found them basically unusable. One member of the USAID shelter team was quoted by Rolling Stone magazine as saying that the recommendations were so bad, it looked like the team never even got out of their SUVs. Another person said that only one of the people that was sent to Haiti by Dahlberg actually spoke French.
Telecom mogul Dennis O'Brien is one of the world's richest people, and he's finding opportunities in the poorest country in the Western Hemisphere. The Irish billionaire is the largest private investor in Haiti through his company, Digicel, and he's now leading the Clinton Global Initiative efforts down in Haiti.
Probably no one came out better in the Haitian reconstruction effort than an Irish billionaire named Dennis O'Brien. He's a Clinton Foundation donor, giving them between $5 and $10 million. He helped arrange speeches for Bill Clinton, too.
The interest of the Obama administration, particularly the former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, you know, all the different things that have happened to help Haiti get up off the floor have been led by the U.S.
And he was the owner of something called Digicel, which is a cell phone company at the time of the earthquake. As part of that relief effort, the State Department run by Hillary Clinton wanted to fund a mobile money transfer service that would allow Haitian citizens to transfer and receive money on their phones. Well, Digicel applied to be the recipient of that grant money. 4 weeks after their application, Digicel actually sponsored a speech for Bill Clinton in Jamaica, and they paid him $225,000. And as it turns out, within 4 months of that speech, Digicel would receive the first installment of that grant money. The earthquake actually has been great for Digicel and Dennis O'Brien.
More than 4 years since a magnitude 7.0 earthquake devastated Haiti. And outrage there is growing over the largely failed reconstruction effort, despite the hundreds of millions of dollars in aid that has been collected and spent by the IHRC, the Interim Haiti Recovery Commission.
So whether you're talking about housing or cell phones, you see that the people that are closest to the Clintons have made out very well from the Haitian earthquake. The rest of the country, the ordinary people of Haiti, not so much.
Haitian activists stage a protest outside Hillary Clinton's Manhattan office. The demonstrators claim billions of dollars were stolen through the Haiti Reconstruction Commission headed by Bill Clinton. They also say Haiti was used as a cover for foreign governments to funnel kickbacks of possibly hundreds of millions of dollars through the Clinton Foundation. They say it was done in exchange for favors that Hillary was doing for them as Secretary of State.
The tragedy is we had an opportunity to rebuild in a way that would give the people of that country hope. Sadly, that opportunity was squandered, and what took place, rather than rebuilding Haiti, was the self-enrichment by friends of the Clintons. For all of Bill Clinton's talk about building Haiti back better, the fact remains that the most visible evidence of Clinton's role in the recovery isn't the improvement of daily life for everyday Haitians, but the construction of new luxury hotels just miles from the folks who have been living in tarps USAID handed out immediately after the earthquake.
We are telling the world of the crimes that Bill and Hillary Clinton are responsible for in Haiti.
But while the world eventually lost interest in Haiti's recovery, the influence and connections afforded to donors from the Clinton Foundation appear to have been lessons learned by others. So how much do connections to the Clintons matter when you're talking about Haiti? Consider the case of gold mining. The government of Haiti had not granted a gold mining concession in 50 years. They decided to do so during the reconstruction of their country, which was being overseen by Bill and Hillary Clinton. What company did they select to get this gold mining permit? A company called VCS Mining. VCS Mining had very little experience in gold mining, but what did they have? They had connections. Shortly after they got that concession, someone joined their board of directors. It just happened to be Tony Rodham, brother of Hillary Rodham Clinton.
It was a true disaster that followed the earthquake, which was the natural disaster. This was the man-made Clinton-caused disaster in relief that led to the wasting of enormous sums of money, the enrichment of elites that were friends with the Clintons, and the Haitians were left in a situation where their life was really not much better than it was the day after the earthquake happened.